cover BSC controls day on October. So before going into actual topic, let's identify the components in this diagram. We have one PLC here, and one on-off wall here, and an HMI here, which is connected to PLC. Now, in our example, we consider a fail to open wall. That means when there is no power supply to the SOV, or when there is no air supply to the wall, the position of the wall is in open state. The default position is open state. When air is available to the wall or SOV is energized, then the position will change from open state to closed state. Okay, first we discuss our default conditions. Say we have instrument air supply available here, and SOV solenoid valve is in off condition, and valve is in open state. Fine. Every on-off valve has two proximity switches. One for open feedback, second for closed feedback. When valve is in closure condition, this closed proximity switch will give signal to the PLC. When valve is in open state, this open proximity switch will give signal to the PLC. Then PLC accordingly will show the status to the HMI, which will in turn display to the operator. Fine. Now we'll assume this valve is an open state. So by default, valve proximity switch of open feedback will go to the PLC. So let us see here. See, valve is in open state, so proximity switch of open feedback is activated and gives signal to the PLC. And PLC in turn takes the signal and displays to the HMI for operator indication in the graphic. Say, in HMI, valve feedback is shown. Generally, in graphics, some color change will be there, like green color. The status of this valve symbol will change to green color, for example. Let us say now operator is giving it command to the valve. So before that, we ensure this instrument air supply is available here. And before giving the PLC command, this instrument air supply passes from this input point to input of SOV, solenoid valve. What are the air filter, etc.? The purpose of air filter regulator is if any dust particles or any condenser or any something liquid is there in the air supply, it will be removed using this regulator. For cleaning purpose, to avoid, it will improve the lifetime of the valve, it will prevent the damage of the actuator, like that. Okay, now operator giving PLC command, valve open valve command from the HMI. PLC on command. For example, this command is for valve. Then PLC will send a open PLC command, which is nothing but power to the SOV. Generally, SOV will be energized with plus 24 DC supply, or in some cases with 110 volts AC or 230 volts AC, depends on our application. In our example, we consider plus 24 volts DC. We will use it to energize the SOV. Now, PLC command is given. So, from PLC digital output, generally via a barrier or relay, the power will be sent to the SOV. Here, the barrier or relay is not shown. So, from output, PLC command will go to the SOV. We will see here, yes, from PLC to SOV, command is received, nothing but PLC giving power supply to the SOV. In our case, it is 24 volts DC, so 24 volts DC is received. Once 24 volts DC is received, SOV is energized. In our example, SOV is normally closed type. That's why the input air is available to the SOV, but it will not send any air to the valve because it is in closed state. Now, as PLC given the command, nothing but giving the power to the SOV, the SOV will be energized and change the state from off to on. As it is space for the energy, it is open the circuit here, air circuit. So it allows the input air from SOV to valve. Once the valve receives the air supply, the actuator in the valve, nothing but the diaphragm, will move either downwards or upwards as per design. In our case, we consider air fail to open, so it is already in open state. So whenever air is received on top of the diaphragm or actuator, this air moves the diaphragm downwards, so that this stem will move downwards to make the valve close. As the air comes to the valve, the actuator moves downwards. See here, moves downwards. As the actuator moves downwards, nothing but the stem moves downwards, and this plug in the valve will close. So the valve state will change from open state to closed state. Whenever this change has happened, respect to proximity switch will detect this change and send signal to the PLC. In this case, valve changes from changes to closed state. So it will send a closed feedback to the PLC, which will send proximity switch of closed feedback. That means this one, bottom one. So it will send a feedback to the PLC. PLC will take the feedback and update in the graphics accordingly. Previously, this is valve open feedback equivalent. As now signal is received, it will change from valve open feedback to valve closed feedback. Valve closed feedback. That's it. Now, PLC given the command. Passes the air to the valve actuator. Valve actuator moves the stem downwards and makes the valve closed state. And for example, now PLC is the operator taking the command from the remove the command from the PLC. So the power which is coming to the SO will be removed. That means SO will be de-energized. That means it is going to off state. Once this goes to off state, there will be no air supply to the actuator. Already some air will be there inside the actuator. That will also be vent outside via this SOV again. Another port will be there, which is third port, which is not shown here. Once this SOV will become solved, this air inside the actuator will come like this and it will go to atmosphere. So the spring in the valve makes the action again to make the valve state change from closed state to open state. This is it. This is how PLC controls a simple on the valve. Thank you. Thank you.